Hello students, good evening to you all. In our today's video, we will discuss about the basics or the mechanism of the physiology of stomata. The stomata are the essential epidermal pores that are present on the surface of the leaves. They may be present on the both surface or the lower as well as the upper surface. So stomata are essentially important for the vital processes like transpiration. स्टोमेटा जो होते हैं वो एसेंशियल पोर्स हैं लीव के सरफेस पे, और किस में एसेंशियल हैं? प्रोसेसेस लाइक ट्रांसपिरेशन, रेस्पिरेशन एज वेल एज फोटोसिंथेसिस. वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द ट्रांसपिरेशन, दैट इवेपोरेशन ऑफ द वाटर फ्रॉम द लीव्स थ्रू द स्टोमेटल पोर्स और थ्रू द स्टोमेटा इज कॉल्ड ट्रांसपिरेशन. सो ट्रांसपिरेशन इज अ नेसेसरी इविल. ट्रांसपिरेशन को नेसेसरी इविल बोलते हैं. नेसेसरी इसलिए बिकॉज वाटर के अपटेक के लिए मीन्स एब्जॉर्प्शन के लिए एज वेल एज ट्रांसपोर्ट के लिए द ट्रांसपिरेशन प्रोसेस इज बींग वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट और द क्रूशियल दैट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड. बिकॉज इन द पैसिव ट्रांसपोर्ट और द पैसिव एब्जॉर्प्शन ट्रांसपिरेशन इज द मेन मैकेनिज्म. ट्रांसपिरेशन पुल थ्योरी में भी हमने पढ़ाया कि अगर ट्रांसपिरेशन नहीं होगा तो पानी ऊपर नहीं चढ़ पाएगा कभी भी. एंड प्लांट नीड मच ऑफ द वाटर फॉर दियर वाइटल प्रोसेसेस लाइक रेस्पिरेशन एंड दी फोटोसिंथेसिस. रेस्पिरेशन में या फोटोसिंथेसिस में गैसियस एक्सचेंज के लिए CO2 और ऑक्सीजन के एक्सचेंज के लिए द स्टोमेटा आर वेरी एसेंशियल. सो इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द फिजियोलॉजी ऑफ स्टोमेटा, सो फिजियोलॉजी ऑफ स्टोमेटा मेनली रेफर्स टू द ओपनिंग एंड क्लोजिंग ऑफ द स्टोमेटा. सो दिस वी विल डिस्कस. So far we discussed that how the stomata are being important in the life cycle of the plant. So generally the stomata in a plant remains open during the daytime. In normal plants the stomata remain open during the daytime and remain closed during the night time. We will quickly see the structure of the stomata or the diagram of the stomata. So stomata are generally stomal, here is the stomal pore. These are the microfibrils which regulate the opening and closing of the stomata. Surrounding these pores are the guard cells. And surrounding the guard cells, these guard cells are present in the epidermal cells or the epidermal tissue. Surrounding the guard cells are the subsidiary cells. The helping cells of the guard cells are called the subsidiary cells. Okay, so whenever this stomal pore will remain intact, so the stomata will remain closed. Whenever this stomal pore will become broad, so stomata will open. So generally stomata will open during the daytime because for the process of the photosynthesis there might occur the change of the gases like carbon dioxide and the oxygen. The oxygen is being liberated during the process of the photosynthesis and the carbon dioxide is being required in the process of the respiration, sorry, in the process of the photosynthesis. So for the gaseous exchange the stomata remains open. If stomata remain open, so there will be more transpiration. तो अगर ज़्यादा transpiration होगा तो सारा water loss भी हो सकता है, इसलिए stomata जो होते हैं वो fluctuate करते रहते हैं, but generally remain open during the daytime and remain closed during the night time. So this opening and closing of stomata is called the physiology of stomata. Different scientists gave their view regarding the opening and closing of the stomata, regarding the mechanism or the forces for the opening and closing of stomata. Several theories were given, some were rejected, some were accepted. Among them, the most accepted theory was the active potassium pump theory, which we will discuss in detail later in upcoming videos. But there was a one thing which was common during the opening and the closing of stomata. It was the turgidity of the guard cells. We are studying the plant-water relationship. Now you know very well that what is the turgidity. Turgidity arises due to the endosmosis of the water. Whenever the water comes inside a cell, it will create a pressure on the wall which is called the turgor pressure. And more will be the turgor pressure, more will be the turgidity of the cell. So all scientists gave a common view that the turgidity of the guard cells is responsible for the opening and closing of the stomata. The reasons for increasing the turgidity could be different in different theories. So what happened according to the turgidity? Whenever the guard cells will be turgid, the stomata will open. Means during the turgidity, the stomata will open. When they will be less turgid or the turgidity will be lost, the stomata will be closed. So this occurred during the night time and the opening occurs during the daytime. So let's see what happened. Suppose this is the closed stomata. These are the guard cells. This is the stomal pore. It is almost closed. It is not wider. Now, if the turgidity will increase, so how the turgidity will increase of the guard cells? The water will start moving inside. Due to this water movement, the guard cell will become turgid. Let me more correctly draw it. So if the water is being coming out, so these guard cells will become turgid and stretch due to turgidity. So after stretching, they will look like this. Now the size has been stretched due to the inward movement of water or due to the turgidity. So as a result of this, this stomatal pore will become wider. And whenever this stomatal pore will become wider, thus the stomata will open. So this is the reason regarding the turgidity, that whenever the turgidity will increase, the stomal pore will broadened or widened, that will lead to the opening of the stomata. So the turgidity leads to the opening. Whenever the turgidity will lost, ab pani jab just dobara se bahar jayega, to aapka normal condition mein aa jayenge guard cells and stomata will again close. Now we will discuss the reason regarding the increase in the turgidity. So what happened during the daytime? During the daytime, the food which is stored in the guard cells. Firstly, the stomata are not turgid, the guard cells, and the stomata were closed. So the food stored in the guard cells in the form of starch get breakdown into the malic acid or the different component like pyruvic acid or something else. So this breakdown of the food will create the increase in solute concentration. The solute concentration will increase because the starch was insoluble. It was not affecting the water concentration or the water potential in the guard cells. But these malic acid or the pyruvic acid are water soluble. That's why they will solubilize in the solution and they will increase the solute concentration. So during the daytime, the solute concentration in guard cells increases. And whenever the solute concentration will increase, the water potential will decrease. और द वाटर कंसेंट्रेशन विल डिक्रीज. तो सराउंडिंग सेल्स के कंपेयर में गार्ड सेल्स के अंदर क्या हो गया, वाटर कंसेंट्रेशन लोअर हो गई. तो बाहर से वाटर, बिकॉज वाटर मूव फ्रॉम इट्स हायर कंसेंट्रेशन टू द लोअर कंसेंट्रेशन, सो वाटर विल मूव फ्रॉम द सराउंडिंग सेल्स टू द गार्ड सेल्स एंड ड्यू टू द इनवर्ड मूवमेंट ऑफ दिस वाटर द गार्ड सेल्स विल बिकम टर्जिड एंड ड्यू टू द टर्जिडी द स्टोमेटा विल ओपन ड्यूरिंग द डे टाइम. टॉक अबाउट द अपोजिट मैकेनिज्म फॉर द क्लोजिंग ड्यूरिंग द नाइट टाइम. During night time, the new food is being not synthesized, the photosynthesis has been stopped, and the food will again stored in the form of starch. So those malic acids, or suppose these were the open stomata, so those malic acid or pyruvate again combine to form the starch, and again the solute concentration is decreased because starch is not soluble in the water. So the solute concentration is decreased, water potential or the water concentration is being increased. So as compared to surrounding cells, the guard cells are already having more water, so the water will start losing outside. Pani fir se bahar jane lagega, bahar jane lagega to jo turgid guard cells thi wo normal guard cells ho jayengi and stomal pore will close or stomata kya ho jayenge close. So it was basic about the opening and closing of the stomata, that how and that turgidity affect the opening and closing, and how during the day and night time the stomata remain open and close respectively. So in upcoming video we will discuss in detail about several theories that is being given by different scientists regarding to the physiology of stomata, that is the opening and closing of stomata. The other theories were rejected. The main theory or the main responsible force for the opening and closing of stomata was given by the Leavitt active potassium pump theory. So that's all for today. Have a nice day.